example 1.15 is to obtain the expression for time period of the simple pendulum, and the time period depends on mass m, length l of the pendulum, acceleration due to gravity at the place where the pendulum is suspended. So the method of dimensions requires us to equate these two, but it helps us seriously how to find the powers to which they are related. For instance, the time period may depend on the length power 4 or length power 1 by 2 or length power 6. So that is exactly it is helping us. The only thing is, if the constant has any other unit, it will not help. So this method works only when the proportionality constant does not have unit, only in the case of dimensionless constants. So let's write. So the time period depends on, the time period T depends on mass, length and gravity. If you write that, so time period of a pendulum is proportional to mass power what we don't know, let us say A, length power B and gravity power C. We don't know that. And when you equate this, time period is equal to some constant K into M power A, L power B and G power C. If this relation is true, the left hand side will have the dimensions which will be equal to right hand side, because we are writing the time period. Then when you just do algebraically some manipulation with these quantities, you will end up having the unit which is the unit of time period, that means time, seconds, or the dimension must be L. So left hand side, time period. Time period means the time taken, its dimension is T. Then mass, the dimensions of mass is M. And next is length, dimensions of length is L. Then again, dimensions of G. G is gravity, which is acceleration. Acceleration is change in velocity by time. Velocity is LT power minus 1 by time is T. So it is going to be LT power minus 2. So substituting all these over here, so time period, so the dimensions of T equal to dimensions of M power A, dimensions of L power B, dimensions of G power C. Dimensions of T is T, and dimensions of here K is 2 pi, and dimensions of M is M power A, and L power B, gravity is L T power minus 2 whole power C. Then here T is there on the right hand side, M, L and all there. If something is not there, anything power 0 is 1. So M power 0, L power 0 and T power basically 1. These are the dimensions on the left hand side. So 2 pi into M, there is no M over there. So M power A, and L power B is here, LT power minus 2, that means 2 pi into M power A, L power B, where LT power minus 2 means L power C, T power minus 2C. So if you add the powers, L power B plus C, so L power B plus C, T power minus 2C. So when the left hand side must be equal to right hand side, then powers are also supposed to be equal. So M power A lies on the right hand side, M power 0 is here, so A equal to 0. On the right hand side, L is B plus C, on the left hand side it is 0. Then that means that B equal to minus C, or C is equal to minus B. On the right hand side, minus 2C is the power of T, on the left hand side T power is 1. So C is going to be 1 by this minus goes there, minus 1 by 2. Then B plus C is minus 1 by 2 equal to 0. Then B equal to 1 by 2. So these are three things. Then we are supposed to substitute this back in equation 1. Let's say this equation 1. Let's substitute back all this. So T is the time period equal to K, the value of K is 2 pi, and M power A, so M power 0, L power b is 1 by 2 and g power c, c is minus 1 by 2. Then t equal to 2 pi, anything power 0 is 1 and L power, so this is root L. G power 1 by 2 could be written as g power plus 1 by 2 in the denominator, that is root. So this is equal to time period equal to 2 pi root over L by g.